obviously students are first and foremost students, and then they're student leaders. Right now, I think that one of the problems facing MSA members is they're overextended. I sometimes go to more committee meetings than I go to class. Like, I have more hours of meetings in a week than I do in my lab and in some of my classes. So I think working on expanding, focusing on what different tasks and roles different committee chairs, different members of MSA play, and then expanding those roles to other students so that they can be a part of this shared governance idea, where it's not one person being a figurehead at 15 meetings. It's MSA disseminating information at different committees on campus, and then bringing back that all that information back to campus, back to MSA, to spread the information. Because right now, I think one of the difficult parts is having one person trying to facilitate many roles on campus, and I think we're going to try to expand that through shared governance and have a different committee so that different students can be part of this leadership role that MSA facilitates.
Yeah, along with that kind of conversation where we represent but bring back to students and bring students to representation, the biggest problem MSA has faced since as long as any documentation exists is the problem of legitimacy. There's a good a huge chunk of students that will ask, what is MSA? And I think Paul and I are in this upcoming year, we're going to do a lot of work to create better outreach and really inform students about what MSA does, all our programs that they can take advantage of, and also the things that we do to better represent them. And also, when people say, well, MSA doesn't do anything, there's no power. They can't really represent students. They can just talk all they want. That's part of that shared governance thing that Paul and I initiated, and we think that's a huge step in the direction of finally getting MSA a real voice, real power, rather than just the debate over whether or not we have legitimacy.
And just to piggyback off of that, MSA has more student representation this year than we've seen since my beginning. I've been here since I was a freshman. Forums filled up with more students than it's ever has been, and we just want to increase that. If we have to find a bigger facility to have our forums and have our committee meetings, then so be it. But we want to make sure that we have as many voices at the table participating in debate on real student issues. And that's one thing that I think we can expand on. Just because we're seeing increases doesn't mean we have to stop there, and we want to move on from that. So what is my political backgrounds, and how will that affect my role as MSA president? I don't really know how my political.
He's a CBS major.
I don't really have a background in politics. I mean, some people want to term MSA president and vice president, or MSA in general, as a political body, but I would really label it as a student advocate body. We can try to say that there's politics involved with funding and things like that, and fees are just another form of taxes. But really, we're not here to talk about the liberal views, the conservative views, the democratic views, the conservative views, Republican views. We're here to advocate for students, and I don't think my background in politics is really affecting my ability to run the organization of MSA as president. I think it's my engagement in interests that affect people is what's helping me to run as MSA president, but I don't think politics really play too much of a role in my presidency.
No, I don't think it really doesn't come up too much in an MSA forum. There's no left wing and right wing. There's people who have their individual ideologies, and that does come up because we're all politically minded people. But we work on, the way we look at it is tuition increases don't fall along a political ideology. Students just don't want them. Doesn't matter how rich you are, how poor you are, or where you fall on them. So I think we try to keep politics out of it. My background is pretty limited, I would say, because I'm still pretty young, and this is my experience in the political process, and I think this is healthy for young people because it doesn't saturate you in the horrible partisanship of that we see in Washington and things like that. You really just kind of ideally have a pure view of serving the people who elected you, and that's the way I look at it.
I go to MSA meetings. I've been in the organization for 3 years. I know the organization works. I know its strengths. I know its weaknesses. I've run the organization as president for a year. I've built good relationships with faculty, administrators, staff. I know my advisors. I know people that I can go to for different issues that will help me in my role as president. And I also think that I know how to communicate well with students. I think most people in MSA would respect me, and I think most people would say that I've done a good job this year. I haven't heard too many complaints, and the ones that I have heard are fairly limited. I think running again as MSA president for a second term only strengthens my first term by allowing me to put the information that I know from this year into effect next year as well. And I'm dedicated to this organization. I live and breathe MSA some days, and it kind of engulfs me some days. But overall, I really, really enjoy the position. And I think I bring more to the table than other contenders, just because of my experience and my passion for the organization, for students, and advocating on their behalf. So,
yeah, I think our biggest benefit is that our experience has shown us that you can't just campaign on things that sound good, just to get votes, and then to show up to, and then once you get elected, you know, we're not in MSA to build our resume or anything like that. If you look at our platform, you'll see that we have plans to get things done. We've already gotten things done, whether it's tuition or transportation, a whole host of other examples of areas that we've already begun work on, and we don't want to stop. So I think our experience in MSA, the relationships we've built, and also the vision, things like shared governance and a new residence hall and things like that, we've learned in MSA that you have to look to the horizon and keep moving forward. Rather than stay still and say, well, MSA can't do that much, and where's our role in this whole thing? But we really grab the bull by the horns and say, we want this. We want this for students. And so I think that's actually what's going to set us apart. It's what all candidates should have, but I don't think you're going to find that in the other candidates. April 5th through the 7th, vote for Paul and Paul, because we're two good-looking guys, and with the most experience, we really want to get things done for students.
If you want to check out anything about what we stand for, what we've done, what we plan to do, and how we want to advocate on your behalf, please visit paulsforprogress.com or go on Facebook and just type in Paul and Paul for MSA. We have strong student support there, and mm-hmm. We just hope to build that. So thank you.